We've had this debate within the conservative movement for a long time. And I think, given the last time we had this debate, when Jack Kemp and I were out, you know, campaigning against Prop 187 in California in the early 90s, we've had this debate for a long time. And even if the government wanted to find everybody and send them home, it couldn't if they wanted to. So what's the smart way to deal with this? What's the right way to deal with this? Earned legalization is not amnesty. I will debate anybody who tries to suggest that these ideas that are moving through Congress are amnesty. They're not. Amnesty is wiping the slate clean and not paying any penalty for having done something wrong. Nobody's suggesting that that takes place.
But what you do hear from some on the right is when you give people who are already here that restricted provisional status, whatever it's called in the Senate bill, and I think there's something similar in the House bill, that is effectively amnesty.
I disagree with that. I can focus more on what we're doing in the House. Doug can talk about what's going on in the Senate. But the idea is a person gets a probationary status so that they come out of the shadows, they get right with the law, and during that probationary status, they will have paid a fine, they will pay back taxes, we'll make sure that they're not a convicted felon, they'll take civics classes, they'll learn English, they'll get right with the law, and then after the probationary status expires, and after everybody who did everything right, who is already in the line, gets through the line, only until then, when they're put at the back of the line, can they consider a status readjustment? This could take as long as 15 years if a person aspires to become a citizen and say what we're looking at in the House. That is not amnesty.
Let me ask you one more before. Talk about how much of this is a critical mass of the Republican Party coming around to the position that you're saying because of what happened on Election Day, November 12th.
It really isn't. And so if our motivation is because this will help us win elections, then we shouldn't bother trying. My motivation, and I think the vast majority of Republicans' motivation is, we believe in the rule of law, we believe that we need to have better security of our border, and we want to make sure that we have laws that are adhered and followed, and we believe in economic growth. And when we've got baby boomers retiring, when we've got 10,000 people retiring every day, as they will be for 10 years coming, we're going to need people.